back to my YouTube channel, and for today's video, I'll be talking about Module 2, Lesson 3, Audiovisual Materials, or AVM. So before I start discussing about audiovisual materials, here is a table of contents. So, audiovisual materials are instructional materials, and simplify the complex lesson or messages. So, AVM is commonly used to refer to those instructional materials that may be used to convey meaning without a complete dependence. It also simplifies the lesson, and the students learn more easily using AVM rather than verbal explanation alone. It also helps the teacher to overcome physical difficulties in presenting lessons. So now, let's proceed to the definition of concept. So, audiovisual material is the combination of audio and visual materials that stimulates the learner's visual and auditory senses. And audio material is a tool in which sounds are stored and can be reproduced, and it is media communication that uses audio to deliver information. And visual material is a tool by which can be seen and can be understood by observing the visual object. The purpose of audiovisual materials is to help the educator to deliver the lesson creatively and clearly, and to save the time and energy of both teacher and the learner, and also to bring the learner closer to their reality and actively engage him or her to the lesson. And now let's talk about the functions of audiovisual materials. So first, it stimulates the student's self-activeness inside the classroom that leads to learning and understanding and absorption of lesson. Second, it enlarges the range of experiences and their knowledge will get broader and wider. And third, it makes learning permanently, or they understand the lesson better than they actually do, and they would have the ability to retrieve their learnings and use it. Types of audiovisual materials. So first, auditory materials. Recording are sounds that were stored on CD, cassette, tape, MP3, or phonograph, or audio recording equipment. Or it is a series of numbers that were stored and can be saved and be played hundreds of times. Second is speaker. Speaker is a device which converts electric audio signal into corresponding sound. Speaker also improves the learning environment because it evenly distributes sounds and helps the students learn while listening. Third is radio. It transmits radio programs that sends information to the listener, or it is an effectual system for delivery of education into a larger numbers of people, and radio plays a role as the sole medium for the formal and non-formal education. Fourth is MP3, is an electronic device that plays digital audio files and can be contained the material for educational necessary. And now let's proceed to visual material. So first, poster. Poster is a printed paper designed to be informative and eye-catching, and it is effective to hold the attention or maintain the interest of the students in the lesson. Second is PowerPoint. PowerPoint is a software application, and it is particularly used to present information using text. And PowerPoint is the most common visual materials for presenting lectures and topics. Third is chart. Chart is a graphical presentation of data in which the data is presented by symbols such as bars in a bar chart, pie, line, and graphs, and the purpose of this chart is to give life to the theoretical learning. Next is audiovisual materials. First, television. Television is a system that transmits visual images and sounds that reproduce on screen. An educational program can help the development of children's socialization and learning skills. Second is film. Film, it is a series of animated and fiction scenes with sounds, and many students respond better while watching film and keep their interest and prevent them from getting distracted. Third is video. Video is a recording of moving images made digitally or in a videotapes, or it is electronic for the recording, copying, playback, broadcasting, and display of visual media. And using of video have a powerful impact on teaching and learning. And now let's talk about the programs that edit and publish videos. So, KineMaster, VSDC, Filmora 9, Adobe Premiere Pro, VlogIt, and also this variety of editing apps can use to record videos or edit and put together the raw footage of various scenes. Now, let's talk about the advantages of audiovisual materials. So first, it allows the students to learn at their own comfort zones. Because of different kinds of teaching, the students can work on their own pace while expanding their own knowledge, and also their comfort zones and credibility. Second, it can change the students' behavior. Because of the material that is being used for teaching, it had caught the attention of the students and gained their interest. Third is reusable, or the material or presentation can be reused. Even if you are done presenting your lesson, it can always be reused for the other lesson as an example. Fourth, make real contribution that will be useful and effective inside the classroom. Fifth, a quick way to attract attention and get ideas. While audiovisual materials have advantages, it also have disadvantages. So, it is time-consuming to prepare the presentation because you really need to set up the equipment properly, then test it if it's really working for the presentation. Second, it takes up a lot of storage because you need to download images or clips that would boost the creativity of your presentation and to your lectures. And having so much downloads would result to not enough storage or full storage. Third, it gets too cluttered when too much information is placed on them. So, in the presentation, you should only put the definition or the key meaning of the lectures. Fourth is, it also requires right use because not using it in the right way would result to not appropriate or not presentable lectures. Fifth, it is costly in terms of money, especially if you want to have a good quality of tool and good quality of transition of your lectures. Then, you're going to spend much money to have that kind of quality. Sixth, it needs proper equipment for it to function well. Seven, it needs good internet connection, especially if the presentation that you're going to present are uploaded online. Eight, no matter how high or low the quality of tools that you're using, it will still have technical glitches. And now, let's talk about the three steps in producing audiovisual materials. So first, planning. Planning is the crucial part of producing because before anything else or before you proceed to production, you need to figure out and collect ideas and think what kind of information are suitable for your purpose. Second is production. It is the recording stage and it is the process of combining and making those ideas into educational purpose. Third is publishing. It is the final part of producing the material for teaching and making the material available anytime that you need to use it. Conclusions. The teacher should be a media literate to be able to be effective in teaching and to be able to explore more and different ways of teaching, and the teacher must be familiar with the tools and how to use it before the presentation. So here are the references. That's the end. Thank you for watching. Bye. Body, I'm an icon, man. I'm a girl about a 10. I should fuck her in the best. Make a city run my town. No, I'm a prince here, man. All we talk about is change.